Hey, Fred Minnick here. In today's hot take, I'm going to talk about something that we all get concerned about, bourbon pricing. Giddy up! So the crazy thing about bourbon pricing is that some brands have not even increased since the 90s. If you take a look at Wild Turkey, that brand has barely even met inflation prices in comparison to this 2001 product for $16.97. If you take a look, I mean, you can get Wild Turkey for close to that today. And, you know, Maker's Mark in 2000 was basically what it is today if you take into account for 20% inflation. And then you have products like Pappy Van Winkle. Oh, Pappy Van Winkle. Everybody wants to get all upset because they go into the liquor store and Pappy Van Winkle's $1,500, $2,000, or it's going for something stupid like $5,000 at a particular liquor store. But here's the thing. The brand Pappy Van Winkle is probably at the wrong SRP. If you take a look at what the SRP was in the early 2000s in comparison today, it has kept up with inflation, but let's be honest. The SRP for Pappy Van Winkle is 200 and some change. I mean, come on. We know that the actual real value of that is far more than what the SRP is. With that being said, Sazerac and the Van Winkle family really do believe in trying to keep those SRPs down low in the hopes that someone, you know, can buy the bottle. But it's just not a realistic price for what the demand is for that particular product. Crazy. So sometimes, you know, we have outliers when we look at pricing systems. Pappy Van Winkle is the outlier, and we should put that conversation in a whole nother bucket. Same with, you know, the Buffalo Trace Antique Collection, although I think that's a little bit more palatable. I think you find those a little bit closer to SRP on a normal basis, at least more so than Pappy Van Winkle. That being said, what we are seeing right now in bourbon is we are seeing an influx of $80 to $200 bottle bourbons. And what is happening is these are new companies that are new to the scene. They are buying bulk product from wholesalers or brokers. And these brokers purchase the bulk product from the distillers. Wherever it is coming from, they have aged whiskey, whether it's 8 years old, as we have seen with Kuiper Belt, whether it is 15-year-old or 13-year-old. They are getting aged whiskey and they are selling it to people wanting to get into the game. Now, that cost to get that product in the tub or in the stainless steel drum or however it is that they're getting it, they are spending a lot of money. And in order for them to make any kind of profit whatsoever, they have to price it around $200 just to make some money. They're not in the charity business, as Bernie Lubbers likes to say, they're in the bourbon business. And here's the thing, if you buy it, that means it's gonna keep on happening. So the question is, when we look at bourbon pricing, who do we blame? The fact is, you're looking at the person you can blame. Me, you, and everybody who's in the bourbon game. The fact is, if we continue to buy products at those particular prices, then they're going to keep going up. And the thing of it all, and what no one really likes to talk about, is that maybe we instead of complaining about the pricing of bourbon, maybe we just say this is where bourbon should have been priced all along. See, bourbon has always been the value proposition in spirits. Scotch, on the other hand, priced way high. That's what the stockbrokers bought. That's what the people with money bought. They bought scotch. They bought cognac. They bought very extravagant wines. They did not buy bourbon. Bourbon was the everyday person's drink, and that was the everyday person's go-to. They would go in the store, spend $9 to $15 on a bottle, be very happy with it, and that's what they consumed. Now bourbon pricing is going up. The premium of bourbon is going up, and it's getting in there in that league with Scotch. But every day, Scotch has a product on the shelf for $1,200, and nobody blinks an eye. They just like, yeah, that's a single malt Scotch. Of course, a Highland should be priced that. The question is, it's not necessarily, is bourbon pricing going up, or is it actually finally meeting the expectation that it should be on the shelf? I think that's a real question. I'd love to know what you think of that. And who do you think is to blame for the pricing going up? Is it truly us? Is it the distillers? Is it the distributors? It's a crazy, crazy time to be in bourbon. And I do think we all have a say of what the future is. Hey, thanks for watching this hot take. If you'd like to see other hot takes, hit the playlist and watch past hot takes, and make sure you click subscribe so you don't miss any future ones. Also, if you'd like to become a member, click that join button and become a member, where we get all crazy up in the membership community. But that's going to do it for this week, folks. Be safe out there. No licking handrails, no licking trash cans. And remember, vodka sucks unless it's being used for hand sanitizer. Cheers, everybody.